Hi, my name is Toya, and if you're here to check on me, I appreciate you, and thank you for being new to this channel. And if you're continuous checking on me, I thank you. So, today we are doing a move-out vlog. Oh, sorry, hold on. Because I do notice, that I've been looking at the wrong thing. It was only when you have the camera close to you. I feel like when it's close to your face, you don't want to look at yourself, like in a reflection, that I do it. But anyway, so today we are moving out. Now, before we get into it, I do want to update y'all on a little bit of what's going on. So, So I cleaned up the apartment just so I can give it back the same way I got it. And I did an empty apartment tour. So now I'm showing y'all the empty apartment tour just so y'all can understand, you know, the gist of what I do when I come and go. I think the last time y'all heard from me was a long time ago. What happened? If you have any information on the religion voodoo, comment down below, because maybe you can explain to me. Let me try to explain it to you so I can understand it. I was working Sonix and Cracker Barrel. Two separate jobs. And I was walking to both of those jobs, to them and from them. Days that it was bad weather, I was purchasing Lyft and Uber, okay? What ended up happening is I purchased an electric bike because the Lyft and Uber was becoming to be expensive. Not only that, I felt like I was risking my life by walking to work and from work, especially when I'm out during the sunrise and nighttime. You know, it's still dark outside and I'm just walking and I didn't have any protection on me because I'm walking to work and I don't feel that it, you know, I need to carry that type of item to the job, if that makes sense. I purchased the electric bike and I went down to one job just so that I could focus on other things that I wanted to do. And one of those things was I did want to travel and I did want to finish remodeling my vehicle. Replacing the motor was the next step before getting into the, I guess you could say, cosmetics. Anyway, I don't want to talk for too long, so let me go and speed this up. Fast forward. What ended up happening is I was going to work at Cracker Barrel. They gave me more hours. They changed up my shift. I was making a lot more money to the point where one job was giving me a significant amount of money as two. I'm okay with that, especially if I'm in a good environment. Everybody was sweet, nice, and I love the job, okay? One day, I just come home. And I just get a tunnel vision. It usually happens when I wake up. So I can go to sleep and I'm fine. When I wake up, I feel disoriented. I feel, you know how you look at something for a very long time and it loses focus and it becomes kind of like blurred, but it try to give you a vision, an image of one instead of, of two instead of one. That's kind of like what I was experiencing, give or take. I could not stop it. So I sat here in my apartment for guess how long? 2 months. The last time I went to work was in June. The last time I paid all of my bills was in June. I paid everything up all the way until I didn't owe anything until August though. So I kind of like try to get ahead. So I started doubling up on my payments because I wanted to take a trip. I wanted to go somewhere outside of Huntsville, Alabama. I wanted that for myself because I felt like I was doing good. I'm working hard. I need to take a break. I need to, you know, just kind of like take a breather. My break ended up being inside this house for 2 months when I was just trying to go 3 days, you know, to Sacramento, California. I wanted to go to Las Vegas, Nevada. And I sat here. With me sitting here, I sat here for a week at first. Shook out of it. I went back to work. They was like, well, you know, we'll still keep you on work, but you're just not gonna get as many hours. We're gonna try to work with you. We'll call you. You just can't do that. It's irresponsible. But we love you as a worker, hands down. So we'll keep you on and we'll work with you. By me not working and losing paychecks, I decided, let me just go ahead and pay my bills. So I went and spent my money on bills. With knowing that I can always get another job, and plus with the job that I already had still keeping me on. So I feel like I'm gonna need for to hold on to any funds if I'm, you know, take being responsible. It ended up that they didn't call me, but I want to say it ended up my Wi-Fi got cut off after I paid the bill. And I don't know what happened with that. I contacted them, reached out. They never did talk to me. I got an automation system. And they were saying that my bill was due August the 13th, but they took my off like August the 6th. Anyway, the Wi-Fi kind of like depleted my networking, if that makes sense. So that was one reason why y'all have not seen or heard from me, because even if I record, the time frame that I was recording to stay consistent, it was not going with the postage. So I might have been talking about something that happened to me in June, but I wasn't going to be able to post it until August. That was frustrating to me that I have nothing to do with y'all. But if any influencer could possibly talk to YouTube to make it a little bit easier to download these videos, chef kiss to you, boo. Because even with those videos that I was trying to post, when I decided to post them, I'm like, I don't care, I'm just gonna post something. So, you know, it'll at least keep me active and give me something to do. It started being problems with YouTube. It's taking a long time to upload these videos. And it takes a long time to monetize. And I feel like if I'm not getting paid any money, why am I going through the extra steps? Let me just post this stuff. You know what I'm saying? But each is his own. I don't know what YouTube got going on. I don't know how it is for influencers that has a big audience. I don't even have an audience. And I'm already frustrated. So I just feel like YouTube, I understand, you know, you want to make sure everybody following the guideline. But could we not speed up this process? This process is tedious and it's frustrating, especially when you're in a situation where you're using Wi-Fi and there's a possibility that Wi-Fi might go out, the possibility my device might go there. Like, that's just trying to make it a little bit simpler, because this job is hard. Vlogging your life is hard, okay? Not only do people look at you crazy, but you have to stay consistent and you gotta keep the audience intrigued. Not including, this has to go along with my everyday activities that I already have on my plate. Anyways, y'all don't care about that. Back to the story. Listen, after I sat here, I sat here for like a month. I shook off the funk. I go back out. I get a job. I got an interview. And I went back in the funk. Previously, I have went to places and got evaluated. I've been told there's nothing wrong with me. Don't ask me. I don't know. I don't need no focusing pill. I don't need no motivation, no speech. I have too much energy. And I know this sounds crazy, but I love to work so that I can have money. So I can purchase what I like. And if y'all been watching me for a while, I'm irresponsible with my money. I like to shop. But to cover my own tail, that's why I get two jobs, because I feel as if in America, you need two incomes coming in your home. And it's not fair if they say because you don't decide to get married or your common law or find you your special one when they want you to, you're not allowed to bring in several income sources. Now, I'm not saying that there is a law saying we can't do it, but I will say that I'm noticing that in my area of Alabama, they're making it where you have to work in the morning, like for a week, and then go to the night, like swing shift, that keeps you from having two jobs. Or you have to do your orientation in the mornings and then work your original shift at night, vice versa. It's kind of like you're forcing me to double dip, because you're giving me a job assignment that is due in the morning, but you want me to work on it at night. Shouldn't it be due at the same time that I'm working on it? So once I'm finished, I can go and submit it? Anyways, I say all of that to say, I continue to progress on. If you see me constantly smiling and happy, even though I'm, you know, telling you my story, understand I've been dealing with this my whole entire life. Not only that, I haven't had to deal with it within these circumstances of the exact same thing. Now, I'm not gonna let y'all go. I'm gonna sit y'all here. Hopefully y'all can hear everything. My mother's knocking on the door. So what ended up happening is, my mother usually is the one who always come and get me when things go wrong. And I'm so blessed. I'm so blessed. But I'm gonna let y'all hear our conversation and our relationship so you can kind of get where I'm coming from. Okay? One second, and she gonna knock my door down.
Get a job, but all the jobs in Madison is not really a lot of jobs in Huntsville, and I don't have a.
not box, but I gotta go to my
house. So you don't take the super phone with the vehicle?
No.
So I can fix it?
No, I can't. All I know is battery dead, because when they locked the doors and I had put the TV in there, someone tried to steal it. So I need the doors locked. And then my brakes on my bike stopped working.
I thought you were gonna take me to your religious people so they could fix me.
I need some protection.
Right.
Luckily for me, I paid my bills up instead of me continuing to purchase. So I'm saying this because I bought an electric bike. And I don't want people to think that was irresponsible. Why did you buy an electric bike and you didn't pay your bills? And I'm trying to please get y'all to understand. I paid my bills and I bought the electric bike. It has been, I want to say I had that electric bike for a month now. And I've been sitting in this house for 2 months not working. So understand, when I purchased my first electric bike, if you have not seen that video, go back and see it. I'll try to link it. I have a degree in technology, but I don't have the technology to use to give y'all that perfect pitch. You get what I'm saying? But hear what I'm saying. What ended up coming about is within me buying the first bike, it's kind of like when things went downhill. But that bike got sent back. I still didn't get the full refund, and I'm not going to get it, y'all. What ended up happening to me is they sent me partial, but I disputed it, and the bank put a hold on it so that the company would see that I rejected the partial and wanted the full. Baby, they rejected the entire amount since I didn't want to take the partial. So, we're not even going to get into that because I don't want to be negative. I'm just taking it day at a time. So, after that, what ended up happening is, since my bills were paid, even though I didn't go to work, I was still able to live here. But my furniture, if y'all remember, I had Rent-A-Center furniture. Rent-A-Center furniture, I had one set that was monthly and one was weekly. So I got behind on the weekly, so I could sit both of them back. And I was like, well, at least I'm in good standing with them. If I don't need it, I can't use it. What is this? I have that. What is this?
Read it.
And I have that. I've been using this.
You got what?
No, Mom. You gotta take me to.
Rick, you gotta go to Sean's. I don't have time to go for no damn well. Sean,
find the time. I need you to take me to somebody to get this stuff off of me so I can stay and live by myself. I'm too grown to be living in a car or on the streets or with my mama.
Okay.
Listen,
Mama. I see Sean open on Saturday then, because that's probably the only day we'll be off.
Okay. So, What was you coming up here to help me out with today?
You said,
I called you and I asked you. I said, could you see if you have me in the car so I can sleep back in your home? I mean, in front of your home. You said, okay, whatever, I'm at work. So I couldn't talk to you for real because you was at work. But that was one of the main things. But if I'm moving the car back over there, that means I have to sleep in your car, in the car.
Okay, we're gonna look at this car and see what the hell wrong with it.
What you trying to do? Get it to crank up? Okay, so we need to take the battery out and take it to get that charged up. So let's do that first. And then while we're there, we can get some oil. I'm thinking if I can put some oil or something, it might crank up. You got some oil?
Because I had to change my oil this weekend.
Okay, yeah, Jeff told me that. Okay, so we want to do that right now. So we're gonna get it out the way because it's kind of hot. And I know you've been in work all day. So All right. Now, I'm back. Okay. Anywho, let me say this first. I am not here for any reason to take my life and destroy and tear down anyone. No one in my circle will be torn down and treated less than, okay? We all have a story to tell. This is just so happened to be mine, all right? Now, say all that because I don't want you to think me or my family are bad people, okay? Because they always say the apple don't fall too far from the tree. But what they don't mention is we all have our own identity, okay? And we choose to make the decisions in our life that paints our picture for the world to see. And that's what I'm going to leave it at. Because I by far am not perfect. And I have told you and I can show you that I'm not perfect. I'm just a young hen. Just trying to lay low. You understand me? Now, I have cleaned my home up. My mom just left. She has taken my battery to be charged up so we can see what's wrong with the car. She would like to have the car to crank up and be taken to her home. I'm okay with that because she's my mother. And I have to let that sink in. Regardless of what she do, regardless of how I feel about it, anybody feel about it, at the end of the day, she is my mother. And I'm going to respect the woman that brought me here, because I would not be who I am if she did not take that step. I personally just want to step back and just be kind in my own space, just so that I can learn myself, age beautifully, and enjoy my life. And I love my family, and I love visiting and spending time with my family. However, I still want to be able, after enjoying my time with my family, to come back to my own peaceful sanctuary to regroup. In my experience, I just feel as if me being around my family constantly puts a lot of anxiety on me. And I tend to either rebel or eject. And whoo, when I lash out, it's not good. And I feel as if the reason when I was younger that I was so hot-headed and angry is because it was very hard for me to have just a good long breath, just a breather to myself, okay? So now that I'm older, I'm like, let's get it, you know what I'm saying? My daughter just turned 22, and I just want y'all to give my daughter a happy belated birthday. Okay, I was not able to spend her birthday with her. My daughter, you know, she's 22, she's doing her own thing. But I brought her anywhere. I will celebrate her birthday whenever the hell I want to. You understand me? But I'm happy to have my daughter. And I love the fact that she's making me proud. You understand me? And I won't say me and her relationship is perfect or good. The bitch can't stand me. She can't stand me. She's like, Mom, you always exaggerating. You always saying this and that. It ain't that deep, girl. She think I'm a drama queen. Y'all, I am. But the stories I'm telling is facts, true, 100%. I have no reason to lie. You understand me? I have no reason to tell any fibs, any stories to no one. I'm grown. Ain't nobody gonna whoop my ass. You understand me? So, even though me and her are not best friends, we still have a cordial relationship that I feel as if I actually was able to put in the effort and spend time with her, then we could build something to be so beautiful. But even though we don't spend time like that and she just enjoying life, I'm okay with sitting back out of her way and letting her live her life. And sometimes for me, I just don't feel like I get the same respect from my mother. And that's where I'm leaving it, okay? I haven't been able to vlog constantly, weekly, daily, monthly. So that's why you have to go back and check the other vlogs to kind of stick with me. So you'll understand that this have not just been happening here. This has been happening. You'll see in previous vlogs of me outdoors doing things that I shouldn't have to do. Whether it's washing my hair, doing my nails, doing other people's hair. These days I should not have to do in the outdoors unless I want to, if that makes sense. In a lot of situations, I just have to do what I have to do. So, let's wipe them tears and let's live, because God has not given up on me yet. Ooh, I love it. So, now, that's over with. Y'all get a little bit more. Like I said, I can't give y'all too much because in the South, I don't know what all has transpired before I was born. And I don't know what everybody's story is about the South. But woo, baby, I'm learning a lot. And I was born and raised here. You understand me? In this same place that is treating me like this. I digress. Anyway, I cleaned up my whole shebang. Look at that boob sweat. Ooh, don't that turn y'all on? Look at that boob sweat, girl. It's hot. I do apologize. It's not hot in my house. It's hot outside. So, by me cleaning up my entire home, I am now getting ready to move. I don't have nowhere to go. I have nowhere to go. Or let me say it like this, because I don't want to make it sound like I just have the worst family, because I don't. I'm going to say it like this. I have no planned place in mind. Mm-hmm. See, my daughter thinks I'm self-sabotaging. And I can agree with her. In a way, it would look like self-sabotage. But in a way, I am. Because when things get to this point where my house is empty, my bills ain't paid, I don't know what to do. Because I don't live like that. I'm a person that pays my bill 1-2 months ahead. I'm a person that's responsible. I make sure my bills are paid before I go purchase and buy anything. I make sure I make enough financial amount of money. My finances are coming in is enough to cover anything I want. How I raised myself financially. If I have enough for something I want, don't buy it till you have 2 times the amount. I know that I'm not perfect, but I am not about to. At 38 now. I'm 38. Okay. I say I'm 40 because, ooh, I can't wait. Ooh, a turn up. Grown and sexy. This is for the grown. Hey, and sexy. let me stop. Okay, anyway. Hear me out. I'm 38. The definition for self-sabotage can be defined as, and I'm summarizing it up, if anybody who's reading the definition, go read it. Someone that's not quite understanding what it takes to get where I'm at right now is self-sabotage. In my summation of the whole entire definition, me and my daughter read it together. But in summarizing all of that up that we read like 9 pages. We read a 9-page article about self-destruction. Okay, self-sabotage, I'm sorry, self-sabotage. To sum it up, you don't even make it in life when you self-sabotage it, because every time you make a good decision, a bad one follows right behind it before the good decision was completed. It's kind of like you never actually get to complete any of your tasks, any of your goals, anything that you have decided that you wanted to concentrate and focus on is always a distraction that causes you to kind of like, I agree that I self-sabotage, because when I get to a certain point that I'm not used to, seeing that I feel pretty responsible, I don't know what to do. When I go homeless, and if you go back through my vlogs, you might see, I don't know what to do. I'm just laying there. I'm not going to work and stacking my bread. I didn't stack my money for the move here. I actually had to get the job, get acquainted, get trained. And then what I ended up having to do was taking my money and just be like, okay, what am I doing with it? Because I'm getting paid weekly. And I'm like, what the heck am I doing with it? I'm sleeping in my car. Am I going to get a hotel? Am I going to get your roommate? Am I going to go and, you know, just splurge? And I like, you know, I got it like that. I just went on and put an application and started spending my money towards what my goals were. Baby, take a wide look at my goals. My goal was to put a roof over my head in my own name, because I didn't want to sleep in my car in front of my mother's house. And I didn't want to be out there exposed like that, embarrassing my family, my mother, me. And then I decided, okay, let me be a young lady, a responsible adult, and let me get my stuff together. And I did that exactly to the T. And while I was here, I was settling in and making myself at home. What happened? I don't feel like self-sabotage is busting your butt to get everything you worked hard for and then just throw it away. From what I've read, it's a pattern, it's a behavior that just kind of like slow rolls into a big old ball. So you never make it to the big time. That's like saying, let's pretend. That's like saying I worked real hard and right now I'm in a $10 million mansion. And you saying self-sabotage is wipe my brow of the sweat, blood, and tears that I put in this and throw it away and hand it to somebody who didn't put nothing in on this. I mean, I do self-sabotage because I don't know what to do when bills ain't paid, when I don't have income coming in, when I don't know what my next step is. Now, I can make a way, but it might be illegal, but I can survive, but I can't. And I repeat, I can't live outdoors. I don't know what that, how do we do that? Can I take some notes? Comment down below and explain to me how I'm supposed to live outdoors. Now, I do know, Pleasant? Her name is on the tip of my tongue. Vibrant Pleasant, I think it's her name. Now, I do know that she was living in her vehicle and then she worked her way to an apartment, okay? I understand that we can make a way out of no way, but I do feel as if though I self-sabotage when I get in those situations because I have to break down to cry before I can get my brain together for to figure out what my next step is. It's only natural because I don't know how I ended up in that situation. I don't know how I'm going to get myself out of it. But you get what I'm saying? I was working two jobs. Why would I go and get two jobs? Go to work every single day walking. Sleep in a vehicle, put my name, my credit, and my reputation on the line just so I could throw it away. And hear me clearly, just for all y'all naysayers, I do not do any drugs. I am not a drinker, and I don't go to the club, party, nothing. I go to work and back home. My fun is shopping, and woo, do it get real exciting when I do it online, where I don't have to deal with rude attitudes or finding a parking spot or even having to worry about standing in long lines. Well, hold on, y'all. Sorry, I hit the Holy Ghost. That is my addiction. That is my irresponsible bone in my body. You want to call me self-sabotage or a loser or just somebody who just don't care, throw their life away, don't give a damn? Say it to my debit card. Say it to my debit card. I ain't got no credit card. I'm too responsible for that. Not saying that if you got one, you're not responsible, but I learned how to build my credit without one. Because I pay cash for everything. You understand me? Cash for everything. All I owe is these people. And it's not enough for you to put a down payment on a car, a down payment on a house. You can't buy a car or a house with how much I owe. You understand me? Do not play with me. Now, my daughter didn't mean it no harm, but when she came at me, I said, you right. But only to a certain extent. Because don't nobody successfully bust their feet to the pavement and get everything they want and just throw it away. Usually you self-sabotage just on the thought of, oh my God, can I handle this? A lot of people throw away opportunities before they get them because they overthink the process. Or they feel as if in my life right now it's not suitable. Not thinking about the future, how this might be a little tough right now, but once you get into your way or your career or your path, this might be just what I need. I investigate, research, read Yelp reviews before I make any decision. And if you look at my blogs, you've seen that I bought a lot of stuff. And a lot of times I say, I heard, I seen my biggest reward is you guys. Because comments is what give us hope as someone who's opening their whole life that maybe this was for no reason. And with saying that, I just want to say this before I end this vlog. No, I do not like vlogging and being upset, mad, having a bad day. I don't like vlogging and sounding or feeling like I don't have it together. It's very hard and it also very frustrating because I'm already emotionally tied to something. Already got enough on play. I'm busy. You understand me? And now I gotta go and try to explain what's wrong with me without sounding like something wrong with me. It's hard. It's very hard. I don't like doing it. And for anyone who's watching this, I thank you. Please comment below of techniques that I can use to better this complaining. I'm not even gonna call it complaining. Let's call it my view of concern. Because what I'm scared is that I keep telling myself, I'm okay, oh, it's fine. Because I'm very bad at that. But I'm so quick to say, oh, I'm doing fine. I can go somewhere, somebody be like, are you okay? I'm so used to you smiling. And I'm like, you're so right. How wrong am I to not acknowledge you, first of all? How are you doing? You looking cute. Then it's wrong for me to even bring that negativity in. Let me give you some of that good sweet tea. How you doing? I'm feeling better. I'm fine. A lot of people that commit suicide have said they're fine. They said it was okay. And a lot of people believed them until it was too late. So with my view of concern that I come over here and share with y'all, I'm hoping that I'm practicing a technique that even if I don't get to do YouTube and have you come in to give me advice or help, I can at least train myself mentally without knowing it. So then when somebody in front of me say, you don't look so well, I can finally open my mouth and say, you know what, I think I have made it to my breaking point. You're so right. Can you please call somebody to help? Okay? And I'm saying this because I know a lot of people who watch me or viewing this might be thinking, girl, we don't need to see this. We don't need to see the people out here in the world that's dealing with this horrible life that we already know exists. I understand. Let's pretend that this is not for you, but it's for me. But what you can do to join in is pray for me. If you see any fault, flaw in me, please comment down below because I want to correct it. I don't want to continue to walk around with my head held high when my head is up my ass. But I want to better myself because I don't understand what I'm doing wrong. And I thought that coming to you guys and starting to record my life was going to help because it was going to be able to see things that I could not see. Because sometimes I've been recording and I done did a whole vlog. And then I go back and look at it before I post it, and I be like, I had some on my lip. Oh, what that is in the background? Oh, Lord, I ain't cut that out. Dang it, I should have had the camera zoomed in. Oh, God, Lord, look. Oh, Lord, I had the doggone shirt was flipped out. We can't see it when we're doing it. Sometimes people who's outside looking in can see a little different perspective than us looking outside. Inside looking out. You see what I'm saying? So I did this for me and solely for me because all I know is I am 38 years old and a little rough draft of my life. At 15, I got my own apartment because at 14, I was kicked out of my mother's house. When I left, I told her I would never come back. I built a life with another family. And amongst building a life with family, they was able to help me to grow and teach me what they had. You see what I'm saying? Some people are seasonal. They might not be a lifetime, but they're just right on time. They were seasonal, but they helped me to grow so much. Then amongst coming from that loving family, I found myself in trouble. So I ended up going to a penitentiary at 17. I turned 18 at the back, at receiving. But the blessing was I was able to find friends. Bunch of them. The officers, the guards, the preachers, the volunteers, the inmates, my cellmates. And they taught me a lot along the way. A lot of them taught me how not to go in and stay there. You see what I'm saying? It's not that you went in there and makes you a bad person. It's that you stay in there that sometimes can deceive your mind and make you a bad person or think you're okay to be bad. But I made it out of there at the age of 23. At 23, I go and finish my education. Offices and technology, business management, I proceed to go and work in the workforce. A lot of these companies became my mentors, my big brother, big sisters, because they're like, you really don't have a lot of work experience. Usually kids be out here just, you know, trying to work and make it through college, high school. You was lucky. You didn't have to work through high school. God had a different plan for me through high school, but I think that worked pretty well. So then, around the age of 25, 26, I decided I don't want to be in the office for my whole life. I like being in the office, but I was like, what if I go and explore, travel while driving trucks, 18 wheelers, 52 feet. Yeah, I want somebody slanging that big thing. Baby, come from that experience, and I decided, ooh, what if I go on the road while I'm young, travel, shop, see the world, especially seeing that I was behind bars for such an extensive time of my youth, I lost that, but I gained this. And then when I get older and I can't really do it because you have to have physical DOT exam done, when I can't pass that, then I go back to working in the office. Best of both worlds. And if anything, I can become a dispatcher. So I go on the road and then I start dispatching and telling people, breaker, breaker, you have one over here that need to be picked up. That was my goal, that was my plan. I was like, yeah, I got the best of both worlds. And then with that career, I really wasn't at home. So I was shopping, going out buying stuff, wear it, and then I bring it home. So a lot of stuff I had, I only wore like one or two times because I'm constantly having to switch out my wardrobe due to having a short amount of space in a cargo. My brain almost went out on me. I got it. Cargo. So I had to constantly bring myself home. So what I ended up doing was I bought a storage and ended up living in my storage, like a regular storage unit. It was a 5x7. I ended up living in there. Quit driving trucks and living in there. So I ended up getting the payment, my last paycheck. I took that money and I went and bought me a mobile home. After buying the mobile home, seeing that it didn't need no work, it was old fashioned, I decided to go to Tennessee and go back into the workforce because in my area in Alabama, Tennessee has more on over the road opportunities when my state only had really local. And then mind you, I have felonies, so I couldn't take a lot of jobs that was going basically over the border, Canada, stuff like that. But that don't mean that I don't have opportunities to get new routes and make money. But the problem is I only make money when I'm on the road. So I have to stay on the road. So I went and bought a mobile home. At 29 years old, I purchased my second house. My first house I purchased, but it didn't go well, it flopped through. And I think I was like 25. So I don't even count that because that was a fail. So this one was a success because if you go back in my vlogs, you'll see I was sitting there thinking I was doing something. Oh, I'm a little owner. Let me paint the wall. Oh, that's cute. And then what ended up happening is I turned around and went to Tennessee and got back on the road. But I did it a little bit different. I went to a different contractor. Well, it ended up that a lot of the routes they was giving me was close up to Canada. And the law in Canada, from what I heard, is if you have felonies, you can't go in Canada. But if you slip through the crack and get stuck in there, you can't come back out. So I'm like, oh, okay. I don't care. Let me get stuck in there. They consider this the cleanest place on the whole entire planet. I'm like, okay, I'll sit down. But unfortunately, a lot of companies couldn't allow me to take that trip because that's covering, you know, violation on their end. So I stepped back from there. because it was starting to become really disgusting. Let's just be honest. Who use public showers? You know, there's a lot of people that don't use public toilets. And I mean you, but I can't hold it. But I would continue to squat. As far as a public shower, and then you got co-ed, we're getting to that another time. Matter of fact, let's not even get into it at all because it's too disgusting. Anyway, I pulled back and went into manufacturing. I decided to go and get my CDL. So I ended up getting my CDL, then turned around and got my soldering certification. So I went through classes for both of them, and it gave me a little cute little certificate of completion, and I started working with that. So what I started doing is I went from driving the 18-wheelers to working at the loading docks. So I'm seeing my previous coworkers. They're like, hey man, you ain't driving no more? What happened to you? I wonder what happened to you. And I'm just like, yeah, so I be licking in my booty. So I came on in the warehouse. So it started being that I was loading the 18-wheelers. I get on forklift, take everything off the floor, put it at the long dock, scan it in, put it on the truck, deuces, get back out there. So I'm still experiencing it, but I'm not getting the full exploratation, which really wasn't no exploitation. Maybe they have us going nothing but the back roads. You can't even get on the interstate. The entire route, just for anybody who don't know this, and thank you for the truck drive and see the world, every single route is particularly scheduled out to take nothing but dirt roads, country paths. You see nothing but trees, dirt, and grass. You don't see none of the cities. They go all around the city just so you can't see it. Now, yeah, you get paid a little bit more because they pay you per mile. You see what I'm saying? You don't get paid per hour, per minute. You get paid per mile for every mile you drive, which will take probably about maybe a minute or two per mile. I was getting paid, I think, 32, 38 cents, but I supposed to be getting paid 52 cents. So they give you a little more money because they take you the longer route, but it's not as fun as exploitation and excitement as you would think when you're here. Tomorrow you'll be in Nevada, the next day you'll be in Kansas, the next day you'll be in Memphis. You're just thinking, wow, man, I can't believe I get to go to all of these places and get paid for it. Girl, I wasn't saying nothing but the back dirty roads. And now the back dirty roads, little guy got on oogies. You know the wrong terms? Yeah, they all on the back of the little road. Yeah, that's them. You ain't gonna see no Beyonce back there, okay? Anyhow. Fast forward, I stopped doing that. I mean, I'm continuing to do the warehouse, but I'm not on the road. So I would have the mobile home that I've been neglecting. You see what I'm saying? I bought it, but I didn't move in when I bought it. I was still living in the city in another home. And I did that because my initial goal was to buy land and put the mobile home on there and brick it up and just turn it into a house. Especially with my lifestyle. I kind of really wanted to be in the country just for the purpose of being out on the road and then coming back to the city life is very different because, like I said, that's the country life we're living in. So I just decided to keep it kind of like copacetic, humble, quiet, you know, less frequent people coming through. So I won't have to worry about nobody, you know, coming across my home or following me, you know, to see my routine. Woo. The second reason is because now I have somewhere to store my stuff. So now I can kind of like organize and get things together. So in the midst of doing that, I decided to start my own business. I started an online boutique. It really was an outlet. I did a wholesale. That way so I can get a wider, broad brand of customers. You can either buy one or you can buy a group of it, just for, you know, some of the single moms that have a lot of kids, or maybe for a lot of people that consider themselves teachers or coaches that have a lot of students, that they can kind of like affordably be able to give everybody something. That worked out good. Where my mobile home was originally an office. I had a desk, all of that in the back. The rooms were storage, so I had actually metal shelves that I had stored, and I had inventory. Child, I thought I was doing something. I had a little portable printer in the back seat, so I could take orders wherever I wanted to. And then once I get all of my orders, then I can wait like 2-3 days before I even go home and pack these up and package it out, because I let everybody know, well, that will be a 5 to 7 business day delivery. But they don't know that, baby, I was gonna make sure it got out there in like 2 days. But I said that to give me time to get a certain amount of money before I stop taking orders, if that makes sense. So I had a goal. I chose I would take enough orders and to get this X amount of money before I spend this X amount of money for to deliver or send it out or whatever I was doing. So when they made the order, I was able to print out everything to explain to them, so I didn't have no customer complaints. So it was just really professional, and it just allowed me to get hands-on with my customers, so that really they could be long-term customers. I wouldn't have to really, you know, worry about it. Because baby, I'm saying, in any business, you can get you about 10 good customers loyal. Customers, the rest of the money is just for put back for your kids' college fund or for Christmas. You understand? Them 10 gonna take care of you. And that's what I was building. I was building a relationship. I was, you know, I was really out there making sure the people that I was serving were getting what they wanted, and kind of hearing their side of, you know, what do they want. You know, so it was good. COVID hit. So while I was doing that, I decided to do telemarketing, and I was talking on the phone, and I was selling medication, delivering of medication. And I did that from home. So it made it perfect that I'm already on a computer. You know, I can toggle between two different screens. So it allowed me to be able to work and still take orders. You see what I'm saying? Then whenever I was off of work, clock out, then I go to the order. So people was getting their deliveries faster. It was working out perfect, so I decided I'm gonna remodel my mobile home. It wasn't nothing wrong with it. It was just old fashioned, you know? It was manufactured in like 1985, the year I was born, and I'm just like, baby, I'm still freaky fresh. So we're gonna freaky fresh this house up. So that's what I did. But in the midst of that, I go to jail. I have not been incarcerated in a long time. Okay, so when I went to jail, that took everything I was working on and stopped it. Because when I got out of jail, I ended up moving in with my grandma, which caused me to go and start working with Budweiser. When I started working with Budweiser, you know, I decided to get a second job. So a lot of jobs I'm not mentioning is because that really was my second job. And that job, I really, you know, it was part-time. I really wasn't expecting to stay there that long. The jobs that I'm speaking of, the jobs that I expect to stay for a long period of time, these were my goals. Taking on that, I worked at another job, and amongst that, I started remodeling my home, rebuilding it, you know, because I was going through and patching up, doing little cute little stuff just for decoration. But as far as for my health, I needed to do more because I had black mold in my insulation and on the outside of my home. So what I decided to do was redo the kitchen and then redo the installation in the exterior of the home. In the midst of that, I go to jail again for the same charge that went off my bone. My home was demolished. When I got out of jail, it was no home there no more. It was unlivable circumstances. So what I decided to do was to come and move to Huntsville. But I told everybody, I don't want to live with nobody. I'm tired of that lifestyle. And hear me out. I've been living in Somerville since 2016. But every time I come to Huntsville, I always gotta live with somebody. Now, even though it was temporarily, I still felt like, why can't I just rent an Airbnb, or why can't I just have two homes? I have my home there, and then I have home, I mean, my whole family, my entire family lives in Huntsville, Alabama. So I'm like, why not just let me have a little home or a little apartment down here as well? I don't mind, I'll bust my butt. I didn't have 4 jobs at one time. I was young, I had the energy, but I did it. And the goal was I was going to college. I was paying off my doggone books and stuff, you know? I was getting it done. You hear me? So now we are in the present. I get this apartment and I'm like, okay, I don't live in Somerville no more, but I still have the mobile home and I still have the land. But I haven't been paying on it. My property taxes out there is $70 a year. You have, and I think it's 3 or 5 years if you don't pay, you then put it in auction. It's going up for auction because I haven't paid it. You know what I'm saying? I haven't paid it. And they've probably been sending me letters out there, but I'm not out there. So I have no control over my life when I am at the bottom. You know what I'm saying? And I have had people say, stop posting. I'm not posting to brag. I'm not even posting to tell anybody. I'm just posting from my experience. This is my damn life. And I'm not the one who's gonna live it. Can't nobody live it as good as me either. So when it came, I'm like, okay, I don't have to post anything. But when people come and asking me, what the hell you doing? Why are you sleeping in that car? Why are you laying around and got no job? I need these people to know. Because it ain't no need for me to sit down here and have a 4 or 5 hour conversation with complete strangers because they fear for my life. There should be no reason that I'm sleeping in my car and the degrees outside is 99 degrees. And I got people coming to me and saying, what you gonna do about your car? You more worried about my car than you are me? That car can sustain. It was built to last in 99 degree weather Fahrenheit. I was not. I would have a heat stroke. I would die in that heat in a strenuous amount of time. I would dehydrate. I will lose color. I will lose my life. And you're not concerned about me? Let me hug myself. It's going to be okay. I feel like a teddy bear with this sweater on too. I love this sweater. I just wish it was longer. I think I said that before. Anyway, back to my story. So, when I get in this situation, first thing I'm thinking is, I came all the way to Huntsville to go and get a job. Not one, but two. I went and spent all of my money, wasted it, to get an apartment, paid the down deposit, got utilities, paid deposit, went and got boat bills to pay the deposit. These deposits I don't get back all the time. And you said I did all of that to throw it away. Let's have a moment of truth really quick. If I wanted to live my life like that, baby, I would have went out here and went and bought the nastiest, sexiest outfit, got real pretty with my money, and went and found me a sugar daddy. Come on, let me show you this doggone house clean, because if they try to say that I left this house looking a hot mess or anything, because people be lying on folks. You know, there's a lot of rumors about me. And some of them I didn't even know I did. And some of them I haven't even heard. But I'm going to tell you right here now. Anybody that don't like me because I post my life, you just ain't going to like me. Because I didn't tell my side of the story. Because a lot of y'all been out here talking about me. And I don't like it. Because see, you keeping me out of the loop and not even asking me. And by me being in a situation where one minute I'm in an apartment, next minute I'm on the streets, I can't never tell nobody what happened. All I got is, I'm gonna say this real quick. All I have is my family who's receiving phone calls. Did you know Toya out here sleeping in her car over here at Walmart off of University Drive? Yeah, that's just Toya. You know how she is. She always for the dramatics. Y'all, when they mean I'm dramatic, if you go back and look at my vlogs, I love the face expressions. I love moving because I got the moves. But as far as drama, messy, nosy, bull crap, I ain't never been in it. You understand me? I ain't got time for it, man. Anyway, look at the part. I got to throw that bag away. But I swept, mopped the floor. I even cleaned the windows, the counters. That stuff had to be, that's my cleanest stuff. But that stuff had to be put in a separate bag. Okay. And then we go into here. And then, I gotta mop that again like some spill. And then my bathroom, I'm trying to light on. I think I got tissue in here, that's it. I mopped the floor, I cleaned the tub, I put it all back like it was. So look at the walls, look at the floor. I had LED lights in here. It didn't pull no paint off of nothing. Nothing. I didn't even get to hang no clothes up. I didn't even buy no more of them clothes hangers. I was looking for some more though. And then here's my living room. Okay. So my car's like, let me show it to y'all real fast because I don't want y'all in my business. But my car out there, it's all my stuff is in there. Only thing I have left is this TV, which would fit in the car, but child, people are more concerned about the heat damaging that than damaging me and my hair. Okay, and then my electric bike, which that folds up, and I can put that anywhere. Okay, now, I know I did a horrible job showing y'all this, but I'm on my iPad, and I have it inside of a case, so I can't really see what y'all see. Actually, y'all upside down. Let me fix y'all. Let me put y'all over here, okay? Okay, so you just saw, take this off, chair. Ooh, hush, Lord. but what ended up happening is I ended up cleaning up my home today because I had called my mama and told her, if you can't help me, nobody can. You know what I'm saying? And I did tell my mama that I believe that there's voodoo on me, that she did, and I want it removed off of me. And if you didn't do it, I apologize. I still love you. I still love you, okay? I don't think the world loves you because evil is just evil. But I still love you because I forgot what you want me to do. And I only want to go to heaven. You understand me? I'm doing the best I can. And y'all don't know what you have to do to get in heaven. But if I'm trying, my goal is to get in there. I'm trying to make sure that it's on the path of the Lord, no one else. So what you think of me and judge me and feel about me, I'm okay with it. But you are not my concern. I'm worried about what he think of me. You understand me? But whatever you think of me, I take it in a grain of salt. And I use it to build reluctance against continuing to be that person that you thought I was. So if anything, I'm okay with you thinking that. But the next time you see me, I'm hoping, praying that you say, ooh, she got better. Or ooh, she changed. Or ooh, I like the new her. I'm hoping that I develop a better substantial appearance and behavior that you approve of. So even if we're not friends, we can still be cordial. You understand me? Now, I showed you my home. I explained everything to you. Now, I ask that y'all pray for me. Okay? Dear Heavenly Father, please guide me and make sure that the whole world is in peace. And anybody that's going through anything, Please let me speak up so you won't have to die lonely and afraid. Amen. Amen. And I hate to say that last part because I feel like in my life, somehow, some way, I'm being left alone. So even if I was self-sabotaging, love me for who I am. Because even though I am self-sabotaging, that is a flaw that can be corrected with the right guidance and teaching and in development to teach me how to be better. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, 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 you like that? Y'all play with me. Anywho, I thank y'all for viewing me. Y'all came and checked on me. Ooh, I wasn't consistent. But at least I gave y'all something. Y'all know a lot of y'all probably was like, ooh, she in jail again. Ooh, she in trouble. No, no. The police did come out here because a Mexican who had a machete and a gun, he had a temper tantrum. He came outside with it, is what happened. And a neighbor saw him. And I guess he was upset because he was out there cutting down trees and swinging and showing the stuff, you know, to the audience of the neighbors. And they called the police. And so they all came out here. They apprehended him, tased him, and got him wherever he went. I ain't seen him no more. And you know what? I ain't seen him move his stuff out that apartment either. You know what? But see, I'm not that nosy. I got you. I know y'all like, what happened? I don't know. Only reason I do that is because I'm going outside to get my bike. And I was scared to go out there, but I was like, since I'm out here, I better go ahead and get what I came to get because that's what I did. But anyway. Y'all come in. Let me know what I need to do. Or what would you suggest would be the best option? Before I leave, let me tell you what my suggestion is. I've been to a psychologist, mental health. I even did counseling, therapy. I didn't do it. They gave me evaluation. And a lot of these companies, they give you evaluation to determine what type of help you need. What's best help that you should go about, you know, just so you won't waste your money. I'm thinking, I did all that, and all of them said I was okay. I don't know what the hell they looking at, but sure, please. Now I'm thinking, voodoo doctor. Since I'm thinking that that's what it is, I've been in this apartment. No police can kick down my door. I haven't gotten a nail ticket. Ooh, I've been flowing on that bike. I like that doctor thing. Anyway, and I haven't been in jail. So why am I leaving my apartment? I thought I was doing so good. Because I was like, I got a bike. I don't have to worry about messing up my driving record because I still got my driver license. Then I was like, my jobs, I have good standing with my jobs. I'm like, ooh, I can use the benefits and I can make sure that I'm good and healthy, get myself on track. Then I'm like, I live by myself. Even though my rent is a little expensive, I got two jobs. I can still pay my bills and still have a little fun and take me a trip. Mm-hmm. Is that a link? What did I do wrong? I thought I was doing so good. Maybe that's what is self-sabotage. Thinking you're doing good. Oh, no. And then I thought about getting a pet. But I don't know why I'm going to get that when they can't talk back. But I figured they could look at me and just shake their head. Made me feel kind of better. But then I was like, I don't know. Because I wanted to get in a relationship, but men just ain't men anymore. You know what I'm saying? I just want a friend. You know, I wouldn't mind whichever sex, but I wouldn't mind having someone that don't mind listening to me and giving me feedback. This is fine. You know, I can't hear y'all. What you say? Just put it down in the comment section. Mm-hmm. And subscribe while you're at it. And like it. Because why not? You know what I'm saying? You see me struggling. That was a slap. You get what I'm saying? But just to have interaction, to just sit around and converse with people, just to kind of get their perspective and applying it to my perspective to see you know, I think that'd be kind of cool. So I'm looking for friendships. I feel like, oh, one more thing. I feel as if they say if you live on your own, you're either supposed to get a pet, a tree, and then a credit card. I don't know. Supposed to get something, and if it survives the entire time you live there, you are responsible or whatever, you know. So I was like, what if I go and get, you know, a set of friends and we just do like a little challenge to see what do survive in our friendship? You see what I'm saying? I don't know. So right now I'm on a friendship binge. I don't care. Females, males, let's go. We can go brunch. We can go shopping. What men do. Baby, I sit at the barbershop. You should, you know, I can get my eyebrows cleaned up. I don't got men do my eyebrows. You know what I'm saying? We can go and just relax and have an adult conversation. Okay, let me get up here because this is too long. But I'm gonna edit out some of it. Some of it. Maybe. I try not to edit out too much because I don't want you to miss what I'm saying, because the whole entire video is talking. It's kind of hard to edit a lot of stuff out when you're being in depth. When I'm just talking amongst, you know, my self-care, hair care, I can kind of like chop it up. But when I'm telling you my life story, I mean, come on now. At least I'm not trying to do 50 series of who is my family, you know what I'm saying? Or what state am I in? Or what they doing in my state? I'm just telling you my life and trying to make it joyful, even in the worst condition, worst situation. I just want you to understand that I'm doing my best. You know what I'm saying? I'm doing my best. I'm not perfect, but I'm doing my best. You see what I'm saying? My little edge is trying to go. You know, the girl's trying to flourish, child. You feel what I'm saying? I'm just doing my best. So, I will see y'all on the flip side. Wherever I land, heads or tail, I'm going to shine on me. So, let me give y'all my popcorn. All right, y'all. Thank y'all for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, and please come back. And thank you for watching.